Okay, so we are asked from the graph above. It says the x coordinate will change as I move from the origin to point A. So the origin is the ordered pair 0, 0. So right here at the center. So it says if I start there and I move to point A, which is right here, it's asking what happens to the x values. So we know in an ordered pair, the x comes first in the ordered pair, and then the y. So we're only concerned with the first number in the ordered pair. So point A, right here, the ordered pair for point A is 8, 0. So it asks what is happening as I go from here to here. Well, we're again only looking at the x. So as you could see, it starts off at 0 and now it's 8. So we would say that the x values go from 0 to 8. So that means that they went up by 8. So we would say the x values would increase from 0, so at the origin, the x value 0, and then it increases to 8, so from 0 to 8. Okay, so now if we take a look at B, it says, how would the y coordinates change as I move from the origin? So again, we're here at 0, 0, and now we're moving here to point A, and that ordered pair is 8, 0. Well, this time we are concerned with the y coordinates. So we know that the y is the second number in the ordered pair. So it starts at the origin, so it's 0, and then it ends up still 0. So we would say the y values stay 0, or stay the same. They're 0 still. Okay, so part C says the x coordinate would change as I move from the origin. So we're here at the origin, so again that's 0, 0. And this time we're moving up to point B. And the ordered pair for point B is 0, 7. So it asks, how do the x values change? So the x, again, is the first number in the ordered pair. So as you could see, it starts at 0 and ends at 0. So it stayed the same. So we would say the x values remained 0. Or the x values don't change. They stay 0. Okay, so now part D says the y coordinate from the origin, so we're at 0, 0 here, and then we're going to move up to point B, and this time we're talking about the y, and the y is the second number in the ordered pair. So it starts off at 0, and now it ends up as 7. So we would say the y values increase from 0 when it's at the origin, so from 0 to 7 when it gets to B.